We're going to be making the best kind of scab. They don't itch. You can pick them and you can eat them. It's edible scabs.
That's right. We're making cross sections through your skin with an edible scab on top. Mm. Now for this experiment, you will need gelatin powder, 200 milliliters of water, a saucepan, red food coloring, greaseproof paper, a measuring jug, a wooden spoon, one large mixing bowl, a packet of pink blancmange or strawberry yogurt or strawberry mousse, 1 pint of milk, 40 grams of sugar, half a pack of red jelly, done! 1 teaspoon, 6 small glasses, any glasses you've got will do, they don't have to match. 1 pack of custard. 1 cup of rice pop cereal. 1 plate. First of all, pour 200 mils of cold water into a saucepan and then bring that water up to boiling.
Got a grown-up to help.
So now you want to get 12 grams of gelatin.
There you go.
And then stir continuously so it doesn't stick to the bottom of the pan until all the gelatin has dissolved.
There we go, it's all dissolved. Heat off.
And we're gonna leave that to cool for 15 minutes. You can either set a timer or you can ask a skeleton to remind you if you've got one. Billy, can you let us know when 15 minutes is up?
No problem, Chris.
In the meantime, you're gonna make up the jelly according to the instructions on the packet. Next, take your glasses or your jars, whatever you're using, and pour some jelly into the bottom of each one. Now the jelly is the layer of muscle below the skin. Put them in the fridge to set.
Time's up, Chris!
Thank you, Billy. And now we can add some red food dye to the melted gelatin.
Shall I give that a stir, Chris?
Mm-hmm. The food colouring in gelatin will make our fake blood. The mixture will thicken, a bit like how your real blood coagulates.
What we're gonna do now is make the scab. Take the plate with the greaseproof paper on it and pour the fake blood on the top. We're gonna put this to one side and that will take about 3 or 4 hours to set into the scab.
Now our muscle jelly should be set, so Xand, let's go get them from the fridge. Xand's gonna sprinkle in a few lymph nodes and immune cells on top of the muscle. Now Xand, I want you to pour on the subcutaneous fat layer.
That's good. That's that. I think that is actually how a professional chef would do it.
And now it's time to make the pink blancmange. Get a grown-up to help you with this bit. Hot milk can be really dangerous. So Xand's made a smooth paste of the blancmange mix and the sugar and a little bit of the milk.
There we go, smooth paste.
And now he's gonna heat up all the milk and pour it into that paste. The blancmange layer is the dermis, and the dermis is the pink layer of the skin. And everyone has a pink dermis. It's full of nerves and blood vessels and immune cells and hair follicles.
Here we go, Chris. Right, what do we do now?
We're gonna pour the dermis over the subcutaneous fat layer.
Let's get them in the fridge to set. Here we go.
If you're using pink yogurt or mousse, you can skip this bit.
Don't drop them, Xand.
And now we just wait for the blancmange to set, which will take another few hours.
Oh. Is it time yet?
No.
Are they ready yet?
No.
How about now?
No.
Now?
No.
Now?
No.
Now?
No.
Now?
Now they are ready.
Oh, that's brilliant. I will go and get them.
We've got the muscle at the bottom with the jelly. The custard is the subcutaneous fat. The pink blancmange is the dermis. But what about the epidermis, Chris? It's missing!
The epidermis is missing because it was scraped off. That's what happens when you get a graze or a cut. Oh, so we need to replace it with a scab. And that's our gelatin here.
Oh, this is really good. Look at this. Oh, look at that, Chris. I mean, that is a sheet of gelatin and a half because we made it extra thick. Okay, here we go.
So what we've got now is a scab of platelets and fibrin going across the top of that dermis. And that's going to stop any blood leaking out. And it will be delicious. Well, time to try. Cheers, Xand. These look absolutely delicious. Look at this lovely little, delicate little spoon. Mmm.
Well, I tell you what, Chris, I have been dying to pick at a scab and scratch it all day, and that is exactly what I intend to do. Well, gonna give it a good scratch, gonna give it a good pick, and then... Oh, wait for this.